Okay, go right ahead, sorry, Mr.
So Heather, a few days ago, 39 senators sent a letter to Acting Secretary John Sullivan in which they stressed their opposition towards Nord Stream 2 and encouraged the administration to utilize all tools at its disposal, including a provision in the Countering America's Adversaries Through Sanctions Act to prevent construction of the Nord Stream 2. A week before, a Russian newspaper, Kommersant, informed that the U.S. has no appetite for introducing sanctions on Nord Stream 2. Do you think that should the sanctions be introduced, of course, they could have a serious impact on the project and companies which are engaged in construction and financing of the projects like Nord Stream 2 or Turkish Stream 2?
Sure. So one of the things you're talking about is CATSA. And at the State Department, we've spent a lot of time speaking with our partners and allies in other countries overseas to explain to them the ramifications of CATSA and how an individual or a company or a country could run afoul against CATSA and fall into sanctions. So in general, as a general matter, as you all know, we don't tend to comment on sanctions actions, but we've been clear that firms that work in the Russian energy export pipeline sector could, you know, if they engage in that kind of business, they could expose themselves to sanctions under CATSA. As many people know, we oppose the Nord Stream 2 project, the United States government does. We believe that the Nord Stream 2 project would undermine Europe's overall energy security and stability. It would provide Russia another tool to pressure European countries, especially countries such as Ukraine. We've seen that what Russia has done in the past when they've turned off the pipeline in the middle of winter, causing some families to not have heat, not have the oil that they need to stay warm or cook their food, and we think that that is simply wrong.
Okay.
Thank you.